The police shooting of Michael Brown in Ferguson, Missouri last month cast a harsh spotlight on how a majority black city came to have so few black law enforcement officers. In fact, in many communities around the country, police, fire, and paramedic services remain predominantly white no matter what the communities they protect look like. In Oakland, California, a new effort is underway to change those statistics and give young men of color new career opportunities. Sarah Varney of Kaiser Health News collaborated with the NewsHour on this report.
22-year-old Dexter Harris, who lives with his aunt near Oakland, California, is getting ready for a 12-hour shift as an emergency medical technician, or EMT, an entry-level job in the paramedic field. Harris works full-time and supports himself and some of his family members. But when he was younger, his life was headed in a very different direction.
I just thought I could just run around in the streets and then, you know, make a living off that. If you grew up like me, my household was kind of rocky. You don't have somebody telling you, oh, you can be whatever you want to be. You can be a doctor, you can be a lawyer. So, you know, you kind of start just looking up to the wrong people.
Harris spent 9 months in a juvenile detention center when he was 17, a common experience for many young men of color in Alameda County, which includes Oakland. Here, black and Latino youth account for nearly 90% of those detained in juvenile hall, and school dropout and unemployment rates for that population are among the highest in the country. But while he was in juvenile hall, Harris's life took a dramatic turn when he was recruited for a new county program that not only trained him how to be an EMT, but profoundly altered what he thought he could do with his life.
Come on.
The program is called EMS Corps, and on a recent afternoon, 25 students in the current class were practicing basic life support skills under the watchful eye of instructor Maria Barcena.
Then I'm on the chest for adequate chest rise and follow
okay.
The chest.
So go through APU. Start with verbal. Okay.
Hello, ma'am, sir. I'm an EMT. I'm here to help you.
It's an intensive 5-month EMT certification course for men between the ages of 18 and 26 who have completed high school or earned their GED.
I gotta put it in, this face in the roof of the mouth, till I feel the heart palate. Once I feel the heart palate, turn it 180 degrees.
The program seeks out students with disadvantaged backgrounds. Most are African American or Latino. The students commit to 40 hours of training a week. They get a lot of hands-on practice, like learning how to operate ambulance equipment.
What's the oxygen concentration on a non-rebreather mask?
90%.
All right, and how many liters per minute would that be?
10 to 15,
good.
But they also have to pass rigorous anatomy tests.
And what happens with oxygen and carbon dioxide at the level of the alveoli?
Diffusion.
Diffusion. Where does that oxygen molecule diffuse into?
Blood tissue.
Pulmonary capillaries.
Pulmonary capillaries.
We've worked with about 90 young men so far, and out of the 90 young men, about, I want to say, almost 60 or so are certified EMTs and working in the field.
Michael Gibson is the director of EMS Corps. He says his own experience spending time in and out of juvenile hall helps him understand the challenges these young men face.
They can't get a job because of their juvenile record, or they do not have enough work experience. They end up right back into the revolving door of incarceration. So in our program, we wanted to be able to address those needs, to eliminate the excuses. You need a way to get here. Our offices are down the street from the BART station. Here's a BART ticket. All right, you're hungry. Here's a $20 Safeway gift card. Here's a $10 Subway gift card. Now you can eat.
Gibson says those small donations make a big difference. But what really makes EMS Corps stand out from other youth vocational programs is that students are paid to attend, up to $1,000 a month, and the education they receive goes way beyond CPR.
All right, stand for the mantra.
We have the courage to walk into chaos while others are running away.
Every week, students attend group counseling and leadership training classes. Nearly all have suffered some trauma in their lives, including drug-addicted parents and gun violence. Valerie Street, the Corps' executive life coach, pushes the men not to be victims of their troubled lives, but instead to set goals.
We are completing the roadmap to manhood.
On the day we visited, 5 weeks into the 5-month program, Street was giving a lesson about persistence.
We don't want to be hit coming up the field. But see, that's where the richness is. Getting knocked down and coming back up and knowing that you're making 5 yards, 5 yards. Where's the dreaming? Where is the power of what I can become? It does not exist in our in our communities, in our schools, or anywhere else. They now know who they are and what they can do. 5 weeks of coaching puts them in that status. That's powerful. Powerful. It's the power of the mind.
The men say no one expected much from them before, but now people in their own neighborhoods rely on them during an emergency.
I'm happy I'm on the path that I'm on, because if it wasn't for this program, I would probably be stuck in a box with a cellmate.
I know now that it doesn't matter where I've come from, as long as I'm the one to make the change in my family.
Since the Corps began 3 years ago, 95% of those enrolled have graduated. It costs about $800,000 a year, paid for by local sales tax revenue and public health funds. The Robert Wood Johnson Foundation, which has also been a NewsHour funder, provides additional revenue.
Jumping jacks, go!
One, two.
Those who finish their rigorous workouts and medical training still have to take a national test to become licensed EMTs. The Corps' success rate is high. 3 out of 4 pass the exam, and while the majority find EMT jobs, others enter firefighting, nursing, or community college. Getting the men employed soon after they graduate in the communities they come from is a big priority, says Mike Gibson.
When you look at the stats on the EMS workforce, where it's over 70%+ white here in Alameda County, then that's not equity, right? There's a disproportionate number of young men of color being left out.
But he says since program graduates have started working locally as EMTs and other health professionals, that's starting to change.
Public agencies are now looking at the community in a different light, because now once they see the young men from our program, they work, it breaks down the stereotypes that some folks may have had towards young men of color, and as well as what young men of color had towards public agencies.
One of the companies where several EMS Corps graduates have landed, including Dexter Harris, is Paramedics Plus, which provides ambulance services in Alameda County. New EMTs can earn up to $49,000 a year, plus prize benefits like health insurance. The county requires Paramedics Plus seek out job candidates from impoverished neighborhoods, but hiring graduates from EMS Corps isn't a benevolent act. It improves customer service, says Chief Operating Officer Dale Feldhauser.
Being part of the community they serve, it's helpful. It puts the patient more at ease. It makes the experience significantly less traumatic on the patient, which I think has huge value.
What hospital does she normally go to?
Summit
Hospital?
Okay, for his part, Dexter Harris says his new career and the program have changed him in fundamental ways.
Just knowing that you're helping people makes you feel good. Doing it 12 hours a day, habitually, you know you're going to change. You're going to want to help people on and off the job.
Harris is doing just that now. He's a volunteer EMT teacher at Oakland's Juvenile Hall, and he's looking to take the next step to become a paramedic.